What's going on, Minties? The Uncanny Omar here from Near Mint Condition, and today I'm going to do an overview of the Umbrella Academy Library Edition, the Apocalypse Suite. So please stay tuned. Okay, now the first thing I'm going to do is thank the kind folks at Dark Horse for sending me a review copy of the book. So this is the Library Edition, and it's been released before in this trade paperback format that went actually out of print, and I think it's now back in print. And it's also been released in a very limited edition slipcase that I passed up on. But I wanted to compare, first of all, to the size of a few formats. So we have a trade paperback right there. That's what it looks like. One of the hardcovers from Dark Horse. This is Abe Sapien. It's the same size as the BPRD hardcovers. It looks to be identical to the size of Harrow County in both height and length. Except Harrow County comes with a dust jacket. Now, the mother of all library editions, we have Hellboy. So Hellboy looks to be a little bit longer, but Umbrella Academy Library Edition seems to be a little taller, just a little bit. But yeah, Hellboy retails for $49.99. Umbrella Academy retails for $39.99. Now let's look at this book. And before I open this up, I do want to say I love the feel of the book. It feels like the inside of Harrow County without the dust jacket. Here's what the spine looks like. I know you've all seen it. And the back. The one thing I wish they had done was probably put a sticker on here where it's a Netflix original series. I don't like the fact that it's printed on there. Like on Berserk, the parental advisory is always a sticker. So I wish that they had done that for this. Now, I may be the only person worried about this, but anytime there's a black cover like this, always worried about getting, like, thumbprints on it. I don't know if you could tell, but this little symbol right here feels like it's embedded in there, the Umbrella Academy. I feel like it's built into the board of the book, of the hardcover. So, Gabriel Ba, Gerard Way, Umbrella Academy. Colors are by Dave Stewart, and letters by Nate Piekos. Here's the introduction from Grant Morrison. Now, we've seen that introduction before in the original trade paperback release. Chapter 1, and then the dedications. Gerard dedicating it to his wife, and Gabriel dedicating it to his brother, Fabio Moon, also a comic book writer and artist. Both of them known for Day Tripper. So here is James Jean's covers. So I'm glad that they kept the numbers and the lettering off of it. You just get James Jean's covers, which he did the covers for Fables. That's what a lot of people know him from. Now let's look at the book itself. Really thick pages is what I'm used to. Kind of like it's the same thickness that the pages of the Hellboy Library Edition are. And the artwork just looks absolutely gorgeous in this oversized format. Now, the book does come with its own ribbon. I love it. Love when books come with ribbons like this. Not that I don't like bookmarks, but I'm just a big fan of ribbons. Now, really quick. Umbrella Academy is the story of six siblings that are adopted by this professor, kind of like Professor X, or Niles from Doom Patrol. Actually, this borrows heavily from Doom Patrol. That's why Grant Morrison did an opening, and Gerard Way does not hide that fact. That he borrows heavily from Doom Patrol. But each of them have their own power, and they grow up together in this house. And the Apocalypse Suite is really quick, just the very first story. After this, it's Dallas, and then Hotel Oblivion. Now, some of this Apocalypse Suite and some of Dallas have been adapted into the Netflix show, Season 1, which came out and was renewed for a second season, and should be back probably sometime in 2020. The story is very quirky and almost out of left field. A lot of things happen. And I like that. It's like a really twisted X-Men, if you're a fan of X-Men. Or if you've ever read Doom Patrol, it's like Doom Patrol from Grant Morrison. Just crazy. And there's a lot of interesting and quirky characters. But this is the reason to own the book is because of this gorgeous art by Gabriel Ba. And the colors by Dave Stewart. Now, we've done an old reader, new reader on this, so if you want to check it out, just go to our playlist of old reader, new reader, and we reviewed this probably back, I want to say at the beginning of the year. And let's see, just a little more. Let's look at the extras in the back, actually. In case you've never read this, I'm leaving the last page out, but there is a beginning of the short stories here, which all of these have been collected before in the trade paperback format. They were just little short stories from the free comic book day or just the backups from the original issues. And then we have sketches and an afterwards by Gerard Way from My Chemical Romance, which I haven't mentioned that yet. This is, I don't think I've ever read this. This is Designing the Umbrella Academy. So, I don't think I've read that intro before, but I've seen the early sketches of the characters. So, this has been in the trade paperbacks before. I don't know, that looks new though. And then ads, early sketches of each of the characters. There's that beautiful James Jean cover. Oh, no, wait, I think this was an ad, if I'm not mistaken. Free comic book day ad, and an actual poster for the signing. And, yeah, we've seen these before. Conceptual art. The Encyclopedia Umbrellica. Looks like it's just an excerpt from that, just one page. Yep. A little bit more from that encyclopedia. I think this was I've never seen this cover before, but this was the unused cover for the trade paperback. Apparently the white violin, this cover right here, which was used for the trade paperback, some book outlets thought she looked way too sexy. Maybe it's those mad curves that Vanya has. Now in the show, she's played by Ellen Page. That's her character. I do love this. These are two characters that Gabriel Ba drew, and he was finally able to put them into a story, and it's this story right here towards the end of the Apocalypse Suite. And here are the two creators, Gerard Way and Gabriel Ba. And then other books from Gerard Way and Gabriel Ba, like The True Lives of the Fabulous Killjoys. That's Gerard Way with Becky Cloonan, and more of the Umbrella Academy. I hope we get Hotel Oblivion in this format, too. As far as the binding of the book, we are looking at sewn binding. And as you could probably tell as I was turning pages, it laid over really well. And that's it. That was the contents of the book. Let me know in the comments down below if this was your type of story that you decided to upgrade from trade paperback to this library edition. Or if you already own the slipcase because you're a big fan of Gabriel Ba's artwork. Or if this is your first time reading it. Again, we read it in Old Reader, New Reader. So if you want to check out that episode after you read the book, I'd love to know what you thought of the book and the episode, I guess. Don't forget to check out our Redbubble store where you can get our near mint condition logo on t-shirts and stickers. And we can also be found on Patreon if you enjoy the content of this channel and want to support the channel that way. Again, this was the Uncanny Omar. Thank you very much for watching. And remember, if it's classy and cool, it must be near mint.